Hello YouTube, Songolang here. Today we are going to connect our smartphone with the Xiaomi Mi Drone using the USB cable or the USB adapter it comes with the drone. Well, then the correct way to connect our smartphone with the Xiaomi Mi Drone always will be the same. First, we need to switch on the controller, and after the drone, for switch on the controller is one short press and we keep pressing until the controller starts. It will start with these two red lights in here waiting for the quadcopter. One short press and we keep pressing until the quadcopter starts. One time the quadcopter starts, you need to leave it flat, because as you are going to see here, the gimbal will start to move or make its own calibration, and the quadcopter moves to be flat in a flat surface and doesn't move it. You see, it starts to move and do the calibrations now. Then it's better don't to move it and just leave it flat like that. We need to wait until that process finish before to do nothing else. One time the drone have done his gimbal calibrations and everything, we can take the drone apart. This is one thing we will do always outside, where you have nice GPS signal and also nice signal on your phone. Because in the case of the cable, at least with the iPhone, you will need to have signal just at the beginning for can share your internet connection. Nothing happen if the internet connection get lost. One time you have all pirate, but in begin for the first step you need it. First, we are going to see how we connect with the USB. It's really simple, the system, and for that you don't need to have internet on your phone and nothing. The way we are going to do is we just plug the USB in here, like that. One time we have the USB connected there, we will go to the Mi Drone app. This is a really simple step. We go to the Mi Drone app, we click select, and in here, I hope you can appreciate, we have two options: USB connected or Wi-Fi connected. Because we won't connect by Wi-Fi, we are going to hit the Wi-Fi button, the Wi-Fi, sorry, and we are going to go to select the LAN we have. I have already connected because I make the video from before, but I am going to make the process again for you to see. I'm going to delay this and we are going to look again. This is the USB, and the pin, the password for that USB is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is the default code it have, and we will connect there. We need to wait to have this blue checked in there for be sure we have connected with the USB from the controller. We go back to the application and we wait for it to connect to the drone. Let me put the drone in here, make a little zoom out for you, and we will see the camera already appear on the phone. Okay, here we have it. We have camera, and as you see, the lag we have is not too much. This is because this iPhone is a quick iPhone and the processor work really nice, but as you can see in here, the lag we are having is not too much. It's really good and you can drive it with no problem. The problem I see with this USB is if your phone have not a big processor and don't have a nice graphic card on it, maybe you are going to feel it really slow and with lag, and that will be not nice at time to drive your quadcopter. But definitely, if you have a good phone, one of these ones doesn't need to be too much new. That one is an iPhone SE, and I think the processor it have is the same one of the iPhone 6, and is working really nice. Then the new iPhones and iPhone 6 will work with no problem with the Wi-Fi. Okay, and one time I am here, I just want to show you where is the option for change the Wi-Fi password, just in case you want. We need to go to Wi-Fi settings, and in here you can see the name of the USB stick we have done to that one. It's the one we have plugged in the controller. Here we can replace the password and we can put the password we want. But because that was just the password we have stock, I don't see any reason for replace that password, then I'm going to leave it like that. Okay, that's one of the ways how you can connect to your Xiaomi Mi Drone. I'm going to cancel everything and we are going to connect it by the cable. You will see it's really easy also. I'm going to switch off the quadcopter first. This one press, and we keep holding the button for a couple of seconds. Quadcopter off. We are going to off also the controller. Controller off. We take the USB out, and the steps will be the same ones. For connect with the cable, we first short press and we keep holding for switch on the controller. We will have the same, the two red lights in there. One short press and keep pressing for a second the quadcopter. We'll switch on the quadcopter on. I will put the quadcopter to one side and we need to wait, as you see in here, for he to make the calibrations from the gimbal and everything. One time that was done, we can put the quadcopter apart again. We take our USB cable like that. We plug it into the controller and we plug the cable into the phone. The thing we need to go to do here is like before. We open the app. I hope you can see good in here. Focus, yeah, there. We open the app, we hit next, and in here now we are going to select USB connect. We go ahead there, and in this time we need to go to share internet. For that works, it will ask for the code we have, the security code we have in the phone. And for that setting to work, we need to have signal just in begin for that blue line appearing here and it start to show internet. Because I am indoor now, I cannot start to share my internet. Then I am going to go outside for a second just for get signal in my phone, and in that way this blue line will appear. I go back in a second. Okay, one time I have a get signal, as you see that blue line appearing here telling me I have one connection. One time the connection is done, nothing happened if you lost the signal again, because that blue line will maintain in there. For example, now I am inside again and I just lost my internet. As you see here, I have no signal, but the blue connection is still on. Then what we need to do now is we just go back to the application and we wait for the phone to connect with the controller. Sometimes that doesn't work and the first time, but if it doesn't work, just get out and get into the app again and it will work. But normally it is. Okay, then here we have the app, and now it will appear the camera from the quadcopter. Yes, I have it in there. And hope you can see we have zero lag in there. Look this. It's perfect. It's just working so nice. We can access to all the options of the app, And now we will be ready for start to calibrate things and do all the things we need to do before flight. Again, I tell you, this is one thing I recommend you to do outside because these things need the GPS signal for you can make all the calibration and everything. I just do it indoor for you to see and for show you how I do for connect my smartphone with the cable or with the USB to the controller. Really simple and really easy. The truth is it works really, really nice and is not difficult. Anyone can do that so quick. And it's one thing you will be really familiar one time you fly sometimes that with your drone. Okay, friends, then this is how I connect my smartphone with my controller and my Xiaomi Mi drone using the cable or using the USB. As I say, you have a good phone with a nice processor. Doesn't matter too much what system you use because both are working really, really nice. If you have a smartphone what is a bit more slow, a bit more old, I recommend you to use the cable because in that way you are going to avoid the lag we are having with older smartphones with that. This system is the system I use for the iPhone. The system for the Android devices is really similar and is easy also, but it changed some things. Then I have not any smartphone Android right now. I just have a tablet, and as you know, this controller is made for hold a phone. If you try to install the app in one tablet, probably it will not work straight from the Play Store in Android, but I find one system how you can install in your Android the app, and is completely working. But I will show you that in another video. I'm trying to find one smartphone from Android for make you the video, and also I will show you how you can do it with tablets Android, what supposedly are not compatible, but I tell you now is working 100% right. Okay, then that was the video I want to make you today, friends. I hope you enjoyed that video and was useful for you. Give us a like and also subscribe to the channel if you are not. And as I always say, if you are interested in this Xiaomi Mi drone and know more things about it, just stay tuned to Songolan because we are going to upload more videos of it. If you are already subscribed, as I always say, I send you a big greeting to all you from Songolan and nothing. Hope to see you really soon in my next video. Thanks for watching.